Okay, good morning, everybody. We have some changes to today's service. One is we have an anthem that will be placed after the Apostles' Creed and before the prayers. We have also introduced lectors to the service. Thank you to David Abel for covering this in the past few weeks. Blair Miles will be the lector for today. David and Pastor will continue to handle the psalm reading. We also have more verses of the hymns, and the lyrics will be displayed on the video for those that can see the screen. One other piece of news I wanted to let everybody know. Back on April 7th, Council applied for the Payroll Protection Plan, which is part of the CARES Act from Congress. And we ended up getting approved for that loan to help us cover any of our payroll expenses for the next couple of months. Wanted to make everybody aware. We still would love you to still contribute to help us pay all the bills, but we do have a little buffer there thanks to the Payroll Protection Plan. Okay. With that, let's start off with the first hymn for the day. Hymn number 369, Christ the Lord is Risen Today.
Everybody. Just two things I want to add to Mark's announcements. One, we have had two Bible studies out of the five. If you want to join Wednesdays at 6:30, you are most welcome to. If you can only make one or two of them, that's okay. 6:30 on Wednesdays. You need to let me know if you want to. so I can make sure you get the Zoom invitation. I want to give my personal thanks for the wonderful support that financial support that St. Andrews has given during this time. We've been able to keep ourselves above water, and that's a glorious thing. I want to thank you for that, and not to sound ungrateful, because that's not true. We needed to continue in this time just as well, so we can continue to be a viable church. So thank you for your support. Our worship begins with the thanksgiving for baptism. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By water and your word, you claim us as daughters and sons, making us heirs of your promise and servants of all. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life. And above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who offer their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, our shepherd, you know your sheep by name and lead us to safety through the valleys of death. Guide us by your voice that we may walk in certainty and security to the joyous feast prepared in your house. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The first reading for the fourth Sunday in Easter is found in the second chapter of Acts. A reading from Acts. The baptized devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of the bread and the prayers. All came upon everyone, because many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all, as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of all the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
The 23rd Psalm will be spoken responsively. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters.
You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The second reading is found in 1 Peter, the second chapter. A reading from 1 Peter. It is a credit to you if, being aware of God, you endure pain while suffering unjustly. If you endure when you are beaten for doing wrong, what credit is that? But if you endure when you do right and suffer for it, you have God's approval. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you as an example so that you should follow in his steps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was abused, he did not return abuse. When he suffered, he did not threaten. When he was entrusted to the one who judges justly, he himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that free of sins we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed, for you were going astray like sheep, but now you have been returned to the shepherd and the guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel for this day is taken from the 10th chapter of St. John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus speaks here. Very truly, I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly, I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who come before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Okay. All right, so this certainly is one of these times I wish that I could hear you all respond. What is today traditionally called in the church? Starts with a G. Nah, come on, you know. Good Shepherd Sunday. As we typically know this as Good Shepherd Sunday. I saw some of you responding. This whole image, right, that is incredibly common in the text of Jesus being shepherd and we being the sheep. Right? I can't tell you how many churches I've been in with stained glass windows with this theme. Right? We see sheep all over the place with Jesus as the Good Shepherd. Mark, you had a lot of those images already in today's service. Thank you. Right? But I want to look, there's a lot of, I'm sure you've heard a lot of this over time. I want to look at one piece of the relationship between shepherd sheep, and that's just how dependent the sheep are on the shepherd. Right? They depend on that shepherd for all things, really. Where to eat, where to graze, where to go. They listen to the voice and they only respond to that voice, right? It's this whole thing where the shepherd really need the sheep to be dependent on them. And the thing is, in this case, the sheep are good with that. They're okay with that. So I got to ask then, boy, this really would have been one of these times you got to envision it. I would have walked down off and started asking for responses from the congregation. All right. You just got, how many here would like to be dependent or independent? We start this independent thing from little on up. Hey, I can walk by myself now. I can tie my shoes by myself now. I can do my ABCs by myself. We do this with our little ones from the beginning, right? Teaching independence. It doesn't get any different, right? How hard is it for us to ask for or accept help? You know, we would rather do it ourselves. Thank you very much. And somehow there's something wrong with asking for help, a sign of weakness. Ugh. Well, your pastor's no different. You know, 20 plus years ago when I was diagnosed with a seizure disorder, now it's 20 plus years ago and we're good. Right? But at the time, I lost my license for 7 months. Now, how does a pastor be a pastor without a car in a suburban congregation? Right? Now, the congregation was absolutely wonderful, positive, got me wherever I needed to go, no questions asked. People drove me, I went and visited people, they sat in the car and read a book. That this is what they did. I can tell you, being dependent like that, was not a happy camper. I wanted the independence. I wanted to be able to be not dependent. It is this thing that we do, right? But, you know, think about those sheep for a second. When they choose not to be dependent and they go off on their own, what are they putting at risk? Right? But their lives. Then they become fodder for the wolves. The wolves just wait for that to happen. Right? And this is the whole thing. They are safer, better, well-fed, well-watered, the whole thing, if they're listening to the shepherd and feeling dependent on the shepherd. That's the challenge here, isn't it? Is to be dependent on Jesus. That can be tough, can't it? And that sense is of how that works is that means we're dependent on each other. If anything that it taught me when I couldn't drive was that very sense of together as a congregation, we made that work. We made it happen. And while it was a big hiccup in my life, it became not a hiccup for the congregation because we learned, or I learned in a better way, to be dependent or to be together. Now, I can't imagine this is going to be any different here, right? As we learn to be dependent on each other. I know it's hard right now with this lousy pandemic, but there's a lot of great things that can happen at St. Andrews, isn't there? All your dreams, all the kinds of things that you're hoping happens, right? All of that can happen, and it can. This is the good news here. As we do it together, I have been thrilled with how this congregation has tried very hard to connect, even though we can't see each other face to face. That is a sign of immeasurable strength, of dependence on God, of dependence on each other. Right? And that is the key. Together. We don't do it alone. As much as we want to do this independence thing, Jesus would rather pick us up and hold us. There's wonderful images of Jesus in a field holding the sheep, right? That's how we do this. There's great things coming, my dear friends. There are great things coming. And I know they're going to be great because we're going to do it together, and we do it with a God who will lead us. Amen.
Okay, now up we have hymn number 782, My Shepherd, You Supply My Need.
Pause now to confess our faith by using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
And now the anthem, Mark.
Pause now for prayer. uplifted by the promise of hope, of healing and resurrection. We join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need.
Shepherding God, we thank you for the educational ministries of your church. Enrich the work of teachers, professors, mentors, advisors, and faculty at colleges, seminaries, and learning sites. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Creating God, we praise you for those who maintain and operate farm equipment, for those who plant and harvest crops, for local farmers markets, and for those involved in agriculture of any kind. Strengthen their hands as they feed the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guiding God, no one should be in want. Bid the nations to return to your paths of righteousness and inspire our leaders to walk in your ways, so that all may have the opportunity to live abundantly and sustainably. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comforting God, you carry us tenderly. We pray for those who are overshadowed by anxiety and overwhelmed with suffering, especially Marlon, Diane, Shirley, Ruth, Doreen, Pastor Dufresne, Pam, Jim, Corey, Melissa, and those we now name silently in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Nurturing God, you desire justice for the hungry. Bless advocacy work, food pantries, and feeding ministries in our congregations. May none of our neighbors lack for basic needs. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving God, we pray for the churches of the Northeast PA Synod, their pastors, staffs, and the Synod staff. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Everlasting God, your beloved have heard your voice. You have called them by name and guided them to your side in death. We thank you for their lives of faithful witness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Heavenly God, our minds and thoughts go out to you because of this pandemic. We pray, dear God, that you would comfort us and that you'd be with us. We pray for all of those who are suffering because of this pandemic, and we ask your healing power to be with them. As always, dear God, we are thankful and pray for protection for those in the front lines, all those in the medical profession, those who give us groceries, those who do all the things that we need so that we might be able to stay home. Dear God, be with them. Calm their fears. Protect them. And Heavenly God, we ask that you be with the families of those who have lost. Assure them of your promise of eternal life. That, dear God, they are reminded of your great love for them and that this virus is not bigger than you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now, mighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Amen.
And now for our last hymn, hymn number 619, I Know That My Redeemer Lives.
Should know this one.
Christ is risen, just as he said. Go in peace, share the good news. Alleluia.
Thanks